Minasan, konnichiwa, this is David. Doing a quick unboxing of the RG Wing Gundam Zero Endless Waltz Edition. This one just came out today. And from what I understand, it is in big demand.
So, we got it out of the box. The guys helped us. They looked through a couple of unloaded boxes, or not yet unloaded boxes, to grab it for us. So.
Yeah, we had to hound them even though it wasn't even on the shelves yet. But here we go. To do a little preview of the box art, this is your standard issue RG. Shows off the skeleton. Shows what looks to be a pretty kit. And I'm particularly excited for this one because I have two things coming in the very near future for it. There is a magazine exclusive addition to his Buster rifle, and P Bandai has a stand for it that has the full Seraph wing effect, and that's going to be coming in February. But this is the basic kit for now. The first thing that I noticed is that this kit is about infinitely better than the old HG Wing Zero, which was, just to be honest, kind of a crappy kit. It was kind of bad even for its time. It was different types of plastic. The wings were kind of rubbery. But this is, of course, RG, which is way, way better. We have our standard style RG decals here. Lots of really tiny detailed stickers.
And they're shiny.
They're very shiny. Yeah, you always get these really great foil effects with the RGs.
It looks kind of copper and green, yeah?
Yeah, what this is going to be is there's going to be some of the elbow pieces. Some of the joints are going to have those on them. And then you got, like, the head piece and a couple of others, but the RG foil stickers have been really, really high quality so far. I've really liked them on the Astraea Type F. I think they're beautiful. So here's an interesting one. The Buster rifle has an inner frame. Usually, if you've ever done one of the kits like this before, it's usually just two pieces. It's a left side and a right side, and then you squeeze a handle up in there, but this one actually has a frame, and then it's got the part that goes over it that braces it, so you don't have to see that ugly seam down the back. That's great. Now we have some wing pieces. It looks like the wings have a couple of layers. That's got an inside piece and an outside piece. That's wonderful. That's going to give you a lot more detail than the old ones. Those skirts look way more detailed too. That's great. The old skirts were just like a little block of white plastic. They looked really terrible. And here's our standard issue RG mobile suit joint kit. This is your inner frame, or at least part of your inner frame.
These things are crazy.
They are. I don't know how they are made. I have no idea. This is one of those cases where Bandai is doing magic because... As you can see, if you look really close, they are pre-jointed. They're actually fixed onto here this way. And you just basically take them off and then twist them into place, and they're already in their ball joints and everything. They're wonderful.
Renato was saying he worked with one recently, and he was blown away by how those things work.
Yeah, yeah. And particularly our friend Renato, he hasn't done anything like this in a very long time. And he's seen some older kits. And the difference in 10 years, what Bandai has done is just really great with these RGs. And then we've got, the shoulder pieces are actually sharp. This is one of the first things that I would do with the old HG kits, and the non-grade kits for Wing, is I would sharpen those, by filing them down. But you don't need to do that with these. They're already there. They look really crisp. And that V-fin, you could put an eye out with that.
Please don't.
So there's our lovely A-runner. And then our Sea Runner here. Again, these are really, really nice looking plastics. I'm very impressed with the look of it.
Effects powers.
The Beam Sabers. That is like pine tree green. That's really pretty. That's not your standard Beam Saber green either. That definitely looks the part. Wing had a little bit different aesthetic than some of the other series.
Really? What, with the big wings and everything?
Yes, with the big angel wings. And here's some more frame. This is the backpack. This is the backpack that holds the wings. It's actually pretty complex, which is nice, and it looks like it has some locking mechanisms, which is one of the huge problems with the old MG kit.
The wings just kind of fall eventually.
Yeah, they were on polycaps, and the polycaps would degrade really quickly. You couldn't really pose it for fear of that. Now, here is an interesting one. Here is our big, huge wing. This is the casing on the wing. It's not quite pearlescent, but it has hints of pearlescent in it. Real faint.
Satin sheen.
Yeah, it's like a satin sheen. And then we have all these other little bits here. So these are really, really detailed. You've got the feathers here. Even the MG doesn't have that much detail.
You know what? That's a pearl.
It is. So it's not quite the old MG or the PG pearlescent sheen versions, but it's subtle, and I really like
it's
that.
It's a more sophisticated pearl.
It is. That is exactly how I describe
glitter,
it.
It's a sheen.
Yeah, no, this is going to be a lovely build. I'm very excited. And this is the other part to the backpack. This is actually going to be a pretty serious backpack. Those wings, I think, are going to be really well braced. It looks like they put a lot of attention to it. Because, I mean, frankly, this thing is like the most impractical Gundam out there. It's got giant angel wings. What are you going to do?
No one would ever pilot this for realsies ever.
Yeah, so they really put a lot of effort towards making it look the part and making it really poseable, making it defy physics. So here's our other wing piece here. It's lovely.
Can you imagine the engineers working on this going, you want it to do what now?
Yeah. Oh, and here's the Seraphim, or the Seraph wings right here. This is a P-Bandai piece I just ordered. It's like 1,600 yen, I think.
Sorry, US.
Yeah, you will be able to get it if you look at like GG Infinite right now. I think you can pre-order them, but you've got a limited window. So if you think that looks pretty, you better get it now.
Do it now.
Yeah, and basically what it is, it's a stand that has the little feather designs down at the bottom, and then it has these clear plastic pieces that go up around, and they feature clear plastic feathers. So that is just a gorgeous effect. Very, very pleased with that. And that looks like, I can't tell, but it looks like maybe ocean water or something down there.
Mm-hmm.
But it's pretty. I like it. I will be doing an unboxing and put together of that too, come February, whenever it arrives. And here's our manual, the lovely face shot of the Wing Zero Custom.
I'm not making a Christmas Carol joke.
Yeah, don't do that. And with the RG kits, I really love the way that they subdivide the pieces. So you're doing the waist, you're doing the arm, you're doing the body, and it's all very well-defined. It's like they paid a graphic designer to do the layout instead of just slopping it all down in there.
Oh, I'm sure they have graphic designers, sweetie.
Yeah. Yeah, those wings look nice and complex. That's great. Very excited to see how those turn out. And it looks like it'll be able to use the wings as a shield properly.
What we like to call sulking mode.
Yes, the sulking mode. you know, atmospheric entry mode.
Yeah. That's what I
say. Or sulking. But if you've ever done the HG or the MG even, they had little tiny pegs that would go into the other wing, and they would theoretically hold them together, but they really didn't. So they would just kind of fall apart. Also, the wings weren't balanced right, so they would the bottom of the wing, this bottom feather, would touch the ground, and then that would kind of cause them to separate. But this, at least the photo looks really nice, and I have a lot of faith in the RG, so I think that it's going to be great. And then your Buster rifles, it looks like the Buster rifles have a mechanism to hold them together. Again, on the old HG, they had these really unsightly pegs and holes that went out and into each other. They kind of looked out of place, and they were really big for the size of the scale.
Here's how dainty his leg is.
Yeah, he does have a pretty dainty leg. Also, the other thing that you'll probably notice whenever I do my review, but wing kits are shorter than any other kits. They are the smallest of Gunpla. So he's probably going to be maybe a half inch shorter than the Estrella, the Strike Zero, or the Strike Freedom, stuff like that. And then your decal guide, which is holy crap intensive. These RGs. And then it's got a little hero, Hiro Yui, down here.
Is that the I'll kill you guy?
Yes, that is exactly it, the I'll kill you guy.
Yeah, in fairness, my junior high school students do say that to each other, but like not like that. They're just testing their English.
Are they saying it to the boys? Are the boys saying it to the boys? Are the boys just saying it to random girls?
Well, the boys will come to me and they will say, do you kill me? And I don't know how to correct your grammar on that, kid, without getting in trouble. Sorry.
Yeah. Okay, and oh, in the inside here, the showcase here, the Wing Zero in HG, the SD version of the Wing Zero Custom. It's kind of weird. This is the first one of the wing kits that they've done. They haven't done a wing. They haven't done a Wing Zero. They just skipped straight to the Endless Waltz variant, which I guess is probably remarkably popular.
Pretty.
Yeah, it is very pretty.
How are you now?
There's the MG and the old Perfect Grade. That was one of the older Perfect Grades, but it's pretty. Anyway, there you go. There is the RG Wing Gundam Zero Endless Waltz Edition. I'll be doing a review probably later tonight because I really want to get my hands on this thing.
Oh, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to me. have a great day, everyone.
Bye-bye.
Matane.